Los Angeles. It's the city of dreams. Yet, in this land of make-believe, reality and its pain are ever-present, turning dreams to nightmares. Just beyond the lights of Hollywood, the dark streets of real life play out an endless story of drugs, gangs, and despair. Above it all, the glitz and glamour of LA seems tantalizing. But the dark reality of street-level existence is a picture few Hollywood cameras dare to document. Without a dream, people perish. But in this inner-city neighborhood, a new vision of hope has emerged. The Dream Center, a light in a world of darkness. In a building once discarded, the helpless are now finding hope. Pastor Matthew Barnett and Pastor Tommy Barnett are providing hope for the hopeless, a home for the homeless, and rebuilding the dreams of the destitute. The LA International Church is the Dream Center, the joy and ray of light to Los Angeles. Come with us as we document this incredible church reaching out to our hurting communities. Watch the Dream Center, a documentary, unfold 1 week at a time, 1 day at a time, 1 life at a time.
Stay tuned. You'll want to experience the power of God's love working throughout inner city Los Angeles to reach the lost, the lonely, the hurting, and the homeless. The life-changing miracle that is the Dream Center is gaining recognition around the world. Recently, presidential candidate George W. Bush was here to visit our facility and host a discussion on resurrecting inner city communities and the lives of those who live there. This week, you'll hear the soul-stirring, heartfelt messages told to the Texas governor by our very own ministers and volunteers, Billy, Donna, and Jose. Stay with us and marvel at the life-changing miracle of lives changed by Christ. Have a pen and paper ready to take down an important number. Now, please welcome our host, Pastor Tommy Barnett.
I want to welcome you to the Dream Center. Today we have an exciting program that you won't want to miss. I'm standing on top of the Los Angeles International Church, better known as the Dream Center. One of the reasons we call it the Dream Center is because people have come from all over the world to chase their dreams at this glamorous city. Behind me, you see the famous skyline of Los Angeles. To my left in the distance, the glamorous city of Hollywood. For many decades, people have been watching the city of Los Angeles and Hollywood to see what direction they would go. You see, they have set the trend for fashions in this city. The movies and the music have set the standard around the world. But now they're watching the Los Angeles area for a different reason. Rising up in the middle of Los Angeles is the Dream Center, where crime has gone down immensely. Violent crimes have gone down over 70%, and overall crime has gone down over 20% in our area. So city officials, police officers, and politicians are coming to the Dream Center saying, what are you doing? What's the answer? As a result of this, Dream Centers are spreading up across America today. Yes, education is very, very important. And yes, people need jobs. But the only way we're going to change society is by having a changed man. And the only way you're going to have a changed man is through the power of the Lord Jesus Christ. I've been saying for years to you that we do have the answer. Christ is the answer.
People need the Lord. People need the Lord. When will we realize people need the Lord?
Welcome. Today you find the Dream Center in a little different setting than usual. Today we are awaiting the arrival of Governor Bush, who is getting ready tomorrow to present the Dream Center, a faith-based organization, as one of the really answers to changing our American cities. And we are so blessed. You know, we've thrown out the invitation to all the candidates, and Governor Bush showed interest in wanting to come to LA to figure out what's going on. Why has this old hospital been turned into a place of healing and restoration in the community? And so we're going to talk about these issues. We are on the eve of discussing those kind of political issues. And we brought hundreds of people here tonight. And this is a great opportunity for the world to see what can happen with committed and called people who are right there on the front lines, ready to go, ready to make a difference. And we're believing that this will start a new wave all across the nation of other faith-based organizations right there in the heart of the inner cities, paying the price, working hard to lift the spirits of our communities and to lift the spirits of our surrounding neighborhoods. And tonight is the beginning of that. We are waiting for the governor to arrive. There's electricity in the air. And just a few hours after that, we'll be sitting down in a panel discussing what has taken place in the inner city of LA. Why has the crime rates dropped in the Rampart area? 73% homicides have dropped in the last 4 years. Overall crime down 28%. In one specific area, what has been the answer? Well, we know the answer. No government can change a person. No legislation can change a person. It has to be a changed heart. And that's what the Dream Center has been able to do. Reach beyond the outside, reach beyond the surface, and get into the hearts of people where the change really takes place. So join us. This is going to get fun here as we prepare for an exciting next few hours. You will see the Dream Center spotlighted, and we're going to tell the world what those answers are.
Governor, at the age of 20, I came to Los Angeles with a dream. I came my little red Nissan and came to this city, and I had a dream of building a different kind of church. Not just a church that would be open on Sundays, but the kind of church that would be open 24 hours, 7 days a week, ministering to any need that a person had in the community. I remember driving home with my father a long time ago, and when I was driving home, I said, "Dad, is it possible for there to be an outreach that would be open 24 hours, 7 days a week?" And my dad said, "Well, I've never heard of a church or any kind of movement like that," but he said, "Why don't you go out and be the first person to do that kind of ministry?" And as a result, today we're reaching out to 35,000 people in the neighborhood with food and various services out there in the community.
The food truck ministry, as you know, ministers in the streets of Los Angeles. Every day, the trucks go into these some of the poorest neighborhoods, and they minister and give food in some of the worst neighborhoods. And they go every week. They load up the truck, and they get out there, and Dad, you won't believe it. You go to these sites, you see the trucks that are lined up, and just people lined up through the whole block. I mean, hundreds, sometimes even 400 to 500 people lined up every single week being served. We build relationships, we bus them into church, we get these people involved. And now, we have our kids in our Christian school, part of the curriculum of in high school is they have to go out with the truck once every 2 weeks, and they have to go, the kids, and serve and give away food in the neighborhood. And that has been such a glorious experience to see these kids learning right now to become servants and serving their community.
Give the Lord a good clap, Father, for that.
We'd like to just give you an example of when you give people a chance to be helped.
Sure.
They will be helped. Donna, would you just come up here and you can address Governor Bush.
Hi, Governor Bush. My name is Donna Taylor, and I came to the Dream Center straight from prison. I had been in and out of prison from 1983 to 1997, and the Lord touched my heart while I was in the county jail. And you know,
it was a great honor to meet George W. Bush, and I just feel that everyone should come to the Dream Center. You know, it's such a wonderful place. This is a place where I actually have gotten my life back together, and God has truly done some wonderful miracles in my life, and he has restored me with my daughter, the relationship I have with her. You know, I just wish that everyone would come to the Dream Center and see all the miracle change lives that have that touched the people here. And I'm one of them. I'm one of those product people.
First, good morning, sir. My name is Billy Soto, and I'm just another story from the LA Dream Center. My life was in bondage to drugs and all the sin that goes with it. And the Lord alone took away my children, and rightly so. My self-respect is gone. My family life is totally destroyed. And I was headed down a road of destruction. But through the grace of God, I was allowed to give them another chance. And God brought me here to the Dream Center.
Rightly so. I lost everything. I lost my family, lost my self-respect, and I was on a road to destruction. But because of the grace of God, He has delivered me, and he's saved me, and he brought me to this dream center. And here, I've learned to know the true love and the true meaning of Jesus Christ. And now I have the honor and privilege of going out into the street, representing the Dream Center, feeding and ministering to the homeless each and every day for the past 3 years. You know, each and every day I have the opportunity to come down underneath these bridges and visit, minister, and love on these people that are living under here, people with difficulties, be it alcoholism, be it drugs, whatever the difficulty is, I'm out here to minister to them, to let them know that Jesus loves them. I was born illegitimately, and my father was a merchant seaman, and I was abandoned as a baby. My father found me in a dresser drawer, drenched in blood with cockroaches all over me. He had a choice then and there, either to take me home or to leave me. He chose to take me home and love me. Now, I know now that when I was in that dresser drawer, I know Jesus was with me. I know he was protecting me. He had a purpose in my life for this moment, for me to come here and take care of his children. That's the reason why I come every day to feed the homeless.
I want to thank you, Tommy, for letting me come here. Matthew, thanks. It's important for people in America to see what can happen when people who have heard the universal call to love your neighbor, when they come together to see the commonplace miracles of renewal that can happen in people's lives. See, I'm a realist when it comes to government. Had a government met to try to figure out how to capture this love, we'd still be in subcommittee.
And the Word of God says, in the same way, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven.
The great false hope of the past is that what government can do is save people's lives. Now, government can hand out money. Government can hand out money. But what it cannot do is fill needs in people's lives.
Well, every Saturday, speaking of volunteerism, everybody in our church, we try to get involved in Adopt a Block. Yeah. What we do is we take five people per block, and their job and their role is for a lifetime to serve every single person on that block. Hmm. That person has any need, they're clean the house, clean the streets, or help them with food or whatever. Their role is to take care and serve every single person on that block. So we go out every Saturday, every week, 52 weeks a year. We never stop, we never miss a day. And we hit the streets, we love on people, we serve them, we clean up our neighborhood and make it better for the glory of God. So it's a lot of work, it's a lot of effort out in the sun and just...
We're going to do something real radical this week. We're going to spend the night with these kids, okay? We feel like this is what Jesus Christ would do if he was here. He wouldn't be hanging out in the church, amen? He would be out there sleeping and eating with the homeless. We're going to feel the pain that they go through, the rejection, the loss of hope that they feel out there. We're just going to have a great time. We're going to let them know that we love them.
We had such a wonderful time at the squat last night. We got to minister to some of the most troubled runaway kids. Some of those kids were as young as 15 years old, probably there last night. We got to feed them, love on them. It was so wonderful. We got to rescue a number of those individuals off the street.
One night, my son's father was extremely upset and shot my son 4 times in the head. He told me if I didn't make money, he'd kill me. He tortured me, burned me with a hot curling iron. Now, because of it, I'm unable to bear children. But now I'm walking with Jesus Christ. I'm just real happy now, so thanks to God.
God bless you.
Thank
we
you.
Love you. We're glad you're there.
Good morning, Governor. Welcome.
Thank you, sir.
I have the privilege and the honor of pastoring the Spanish church here at the Dream Center. And there's something in my heart that I'd like to share with you today.
Sure.
I grew up with an alcoholic father, drug addict, violence. Numerous times at 9 years old, I saw my father beating on my mom physically.
And I want to share with you today that faith-based churches, faith-based organizations can change a person's life. You see, the government, the county spent almost $100,000 to rehabilitate me, to get me off of drugs and alcohol, and it never worked. But the day I came to Jesus Christ, it's the day that I was delivered from all that junk.
People in my position need to ask this question, does it work? Does it work? That's what society ought to ask. We ought not to be afraid of the power that causes it to work.
Our program is designed for each child to work individually at their own pace, at their own level. But one of the things that I find most important about teaching these kids is we're teaching them personal accountability and responsibility for their life. Each day they have to set daily goals and they have to accomplish them. So as they grow and go through this program, they're learning responsibility for everything in their life, and they can take responsibility for that. We're just raising up a higher standard for all of these kids, and they're having to take responsibility for their education, and that's what's important for when they go out into the world.
This is so necessary for today's generation. They need to know the love of God, and they need to know biblical values in order to grow up into real men and women of God that then will be a blessing to this country.
The best prevention program is educating children. It is. You can't teach children self-esteem. There's no such thing as self-esteem 101. But you can teach children to read and write and add and subtract, and they earn self-esteem. You can teach children.
Over 10 years ago, I met with Bill Wilson on how we might reach the children here in Los Angeles. What came out of that conversation was Sidewalk Sunday School, trucks like these that would be converted with a stage on the side, with a sound system that could roll into some of the most needy neighborhoods here in Los Angeles to present a message of love and hope for the children. The program goes into some of the toughest areas here in the city, some of the housing projects, some of the areas where there's a lot of gangs and drugs. A 1 hour Sunday school program is done there for the kids with songs and games and Bible lessons and skits and drama. Those are the kind of things that are attracting the attention of the kids. And why we do what we do is because these children will grow up and they will either be tomorrow's gang members, which here in Los Angeles number about 150,000 with about 1,000 gangs, or they will be tomorrow's church. They will be the young people going into their own neighborhoods to take a message of hope and love.
I believe if when we change hearts, we change America. I believe that. I believe that.
I used to be an alcoholic and drug user, but now I'm a new creation in Christ. Thank you, Lord.
I heard about the Dream Center when I was in prison. I just want to let you guys know, thank you for letting me be here in this place. Because if I wasn't here, I don't know where I would be at. I would either be dead or in prison for the rest of my life.
I was strung out on heroin for 12 years, and today I've just graduated discipleship. I've been here 2.5 years serving the Lord, and I am set free from drugs, alcohol, all the bondages that just had a hold of me.
It's been everything that it was made out to be, and it's a dream center, and now my dreams are coming true. I don't have to look behind me anymore. When I walk the streets and see a police car, I don't have to duck behind buildings. Yeah.
One thing I can say today is, praise the Lord Jesus Christ, after 28 years of absolute bondage to perversions like homosexuality and transsexuality, Jesus Christ set me free. I just praise Him for the opportunity that He's given me to serve Him after such a great fall.
That service that night at the Dream Center was my outlet, my escape from the madness. I went to the altar that night, and I had the opportunity to just give it all to the Lord, and I accepted Jesus Christ back into my life, into my heart, as my personal Savior, my Lord and Savior, and since that night, my life has just been changed, totally changed.
I lost my kids. I mean, the only thing I had that loved me, my mom was the point of giving up on me, and the churches gave up on me, everybody gave up on me. They said I was a lost cause, that I would never make it. But I mean, God is the only thing in my whole life that never gave up on me. I mean, I've been here over 90 days, and I mean, I have joy in my life. I smile every day, no violence. I'm happy. I mean, if you just don't give up on people, they'll make it.
Today was an indication of where I want to lead. We came here for a reason, so you can visually see what happens when people of faith are encouraged and supported. I'm going to have an approach that is active in rallying the armies of compassion. You had a chance to see how people's lives can be changed. It's an incredibly important part of my vision for America.
Well, it's been a great day at the Dream Center. We've had news media from all over the world here. We had a visit today from one of the presidential candidates Governor Bush. And my, what a speech he made. He talked about compassionate conservatism and talked about faith-based organizations making a difference in our world. And while we are not endorsing any one candidate, matter of fact, we'd like to invite you all, anyone running for president, we'd like to invite the President of the United States, come and visit us at the Dream Center. And I think you'll find out that the answer to the world's problems is Jesus Christ. He is the answer. And the Dream Center, because of Jesus Christ, is making a difference. Right, Matthew?
You know, Dad, today we open up a whole discussion of really mobilizing an army that's already there in the trenches and to supply them with the finances maybe the government needed to get into the hands of people who are out on the streets daily, who are touching the lives of people, who are not just delegating things, but they have their heart is connected to the need in the street. And that's what we're trying to talk about here today, getting some of that funding in the hands of people like us who get out there in the streets. But really, most importantly, we know that what's carried the Dream Center all along has really been the supporters out there, Christian people who believed in faith-based organizations before it was even an issue. But we're gaining ground. People are seeing the value of what churches can do in our neighborhoods.
And you know, that's what blew the governor away and all the people that were here. They said, how could you do what you've done? Did the government fund it? We said, no. Did this one fund it? No. It was God's people, the people of faith, a faith-based organization. And you know what? It's the only way we can survive, the only way we exist. Is by your prayers and your love and your support to us again and again.
There's a trend that's starting here. We've seen it today. There's a trend. The discussion is open. Hopefully it can become a national platform discussion of what we talked about today. If we can get this issue out in the open, and if we can keep on supporting this engine going forward, we could do this all over the nation.
Yeah.
And it could raise awareness. People begin to realize that the church is the answer for this.
And you that have watched this program, that have been with us all these years, there is a movement, a groundswell of Dream Centers that are raising up across the country to help people. Man, we are so excited that the Lord is blessing. And aren't you grateful?
It's what it's all about. He is so good, and we thank Him for all that's happened today. We thank you for being a part of this team, because you are a part of that groundswell movement that's going around across this nation.
It just inspires us to keep on going a little harder. So come on, let's keep going. Amen.
People need
Well, everybody says that it's working. What's happening at the Dream Center is changing lives. The police tell us that crime has gone down. The governor says it is working. We've heard him talk about it today. He talked a lot about education being the answer, and education is extremely important. I'm standing here with one of our little girls here, Rashad, that's in our school, being educated right here at the Dream Center. Precious, precious girl. But I'm going to tell you, there's one more ingredient that's more important than all that. And that's what we've seen at this altar tonight. People accepting Jesus Christ. You can educate a person. You can put money in their pockets. You can give them home and surround them with luxuries. But I'm telling you, until they have Christ working within them, He is the hope of glory. We've seen the hope around these altars tonight. And people have given their lives to Christ. And then they were given a chance to be a part of this discipleship program. And we always tell them after the altar call, we'll keep you overnight and we'll put you in our discipleship program tomorrow. If you're willing to abide by the rules that we have here, we'll help you. Christ is the answer to every situation. And by the way, He's the answer to your needs today. And He'll come in and change your life if you'll ask Him to come into your heart. The Bible said that when Jesus saw the sick, hurting multitudes, He was moved with compassion. And I'm sure that you, like me, as you've watched this program today, have been deeply moved by compassion. And the amazing thing is that we have doctors and lawyers and nurses who have spent thousands of dollars on their education, but they are willing to bypass a lucrative job to come to the Dream Center to volunteer their help to help us reaching these hurting people. And that's what the Dream Center Medical Mobile Unit is all about. Can you imagine, just a minute, a unit like this, a medical clinic and legal clinic on wheels, traveling the streets of the city day and night, bringing healing and hope
and the message of Jesus Christ that will change their life to these people. And that's why I'm so excited about the plan we're going to present to you today. Now, it's going to take about $200,000 to purchase and build this wonderful mobile unit. And then it's going to cost another $250,000 a year just to operate this unit. Now, there's about 80 stops that this unit is going to be making on a regular basis. So that works out to $6,000 a stop for the first year of operation. Now, with your help, healing can come to these men, women, and children immediately. A simple touch, an aspirin, a vaccination, a tooth being pulled. If we could only get to where they are now, we can begin to help them today. Would you help us right now? I can honestly say that your gift to this medical unit might be the most important gift that you've ever given to the Dream Center. Now, some of you could send $60. Some of you could send $600. Some of you could bear the entire stop for 1 year for $6,000. And you know what? There might be someone that could bear the entire gift of $200,000 for this unit. If we'll put our hearts together, we can do something great for God. Now, would you go to the phone right now and call in that number on your line and either put it on your bank card or make a check out to the Dream Center? When you do, we're going to send you our wonderful music CD for a gift of $25 or more to the Dream Center. We'd love to send this to you. Now, many of you have intended for a long time to help the Dream Center, but you just put it off. I want you to go to the phone right now and make that call and help us bring healing unto those that need help. Thank you so much. God bless you.
When you're in the Los Angeles area, we hope you'll join us for an English language service at the Dream Center on Thursdays at 7 p.m. and on Sunday mornings at 9:15 and 11 a.m. Also, visit our website at www.dreamcenter.org. That's www.dreamcenter.org.
Out.